All right, so we're coming down below, and as you can see, that was just really gradual coming down. The steps themselves have been angled, so it gives you a really easy entry into the salon of the vessel. But we're standing here in the galley, and this is quite a unique galley. Now, you've probably seen from other 509 or 519 videos, but this is the T-shaped galley. So one thing I really like about it is it gives you so much countertop space. We have double stainless steel sinks. We have a top-loading dedicated freezer. We have a top and side-loading dedicated refrigerator with small freezer compartment located in that as well too. Just aft of that is our three-burner stove and oven. We have a nice overhead opening hatch as well too, and tremendous amounts of stowage space throughout the galley. It's quite impressive. Just behind the lid here to the fridge is our built-in microwave. And again, you can see just how much storage this really possesses. It's quite impressive and quite unique. So a phenomenal galley, definitely will make any chef and your family quite happy. Just forward of that to the extension of the galley is a really amazing pull-out drawer. So this is where all your silverware and utensils go. Located below that is an additional stowage area. This particular area, you could get an additional fridge, freezer, or even an ice maker or a dishwasher if you so desire. Now, directly aft of the galley is our second stateroom. Now, this particular stateroom here is quite large. You have a nice built-in cabinetry, really finishing it off. And we have a full hanging locker cabinet here. You can also see the LED lighting that is brought in. It really makes it nice and bright. We have a side port giving us great visual with aviation style shades. We have another deck port there, and we have an overhead opening hatch and a side opening hatch letting lots of natural light and ventilation into this area. We have engine access into this area as well too. And again, additional cabinetry, just everything is just really well finished out. Now below the beds themselves house the batteries. So this is one section of batteries. So you can see we have three batteries here and an isolated engine start battery. On the opposite side, on the other second stateroom, I will show you the additional battery space. Again, we talked about the gradual steps here. Let me just show you this right here while we're at it. This is access to the engine. Now, earlier I said that was an isolated engine start battery. I take that back. That was the isolated generator battery back there. This is the isolated engine start battery. And then we have additional house battery banks on the opposite side. But this is a very well insulated engine room here. We have our primary fuel filter. And you see this pump right here? So if you ever did run it out or get an airlock, you're able to manually pump that here. We have our sea strainer right up forward. Again, great easy accessibility to everything, and our water pump is located right up front as well too. So I really love the engine room. It's really well thought out. Now making our way to the VIP stateroom. The reason I call this the VIP stateroom is you have access into the head and shower as well too. So with this door being closed off, you can have day head access or private VIP access. This head is quite nice. It's at a Japsco electric quiet flush toilet. It has a separate shower stall with a smoked glass divider, and then a really nice molded countertop sink and lots of stowage found in here. So just after that is our stateroom. This is identical mattress to the starboard side stateroom. Cabinetry throughout everywhere, great engine room access, huge hanging locker closet that just possesses, you know, lots of great areas for stowage. We have our air conditioning and heating controls here, and this aft control does climate control for the other aft stateroom as well too. But now below this bed, these are two additional house battery banks. This is our fuses for our charging system and what have you, so really easy access here. We have breakers that are located down here for all of our electric winches, our windlass, and our battery shutoff switches. We also have the second fuel tank diverter valve that's located here. So by pulling this out, it'll actually divert to the second fuel tank, so you can utilize that as well too. Now making your way back into the salon, another thing I want to point out is this is the very first Jeannot 519 with the new light oak interior. And I find it to be just absolutely stunning. It's light, it's airy, it has a solid just wood feel finish to it. This is an open porous wood as well too, so it just really has a nice overall texture to it. The nav station itself is quite nice. This is a large nav station. You can have all of your maps out here. You have lots of stowage and additional stowage here. Down below, you can actually see a nice magazine rack, a map chart storage. This opens up. So every inch of space has really been utilized quite nicely. Now what we brought in from the factory is the flat panel monitoring system. Now you can tie this into your GPS if you so desire, or mount your flat screen television to it and have all of your viewing needs here. We have our Raymarine VHF. This is our master volt inverter control. We have our 110, our 12 volt distribution panel, our Fusion Stereo CD, a DVD player, our generator, start and stop switches here, and this is the remote for the inverter. Just forward of that is our diverter switches for our ship to shore power. So within a moment, you can actually switch it over to ship while the generator's running and supply all of your 110 units from the generator. Air conditioning, outlets, microwave, television, all of that could be supplied. But again, a really nice area. I love how they've integrated this into a bench, a lounge seat. So it's quite nice. Just forward of me is the salon table. The salon table is the luxury salon table. And so what that does is it houses area for six bottles of wine or additional goods if you so desire. You see these beautiful hinges here. This hinges back, making it a full table. So it's quite nice. And then when not in use, you can hinge it over here and then have great easy access into here. There's additional stowage underneath all of this seating. And with the lift of a cabinet there, you can see this is a full dedicated wine locker as well too, or we're housing all of the manuals. Lots of subsole stowage. I really like how Jeannot's done flush hatches. I mean, you can see that it's flush into here. It's a lot of little attention to detail like that that really sets the Jeannot apart. The nice big deep bilges, you can put big Tupperwares down here, stow lots of goods and what have you. So lots of stowage space found throughout the subfloor as well too. Now off to the starboard side is our bench seat. I really like the attention to detail with these backrests that are easily accessible. They fold out and you can actually have additional stowage back in there. So that's nice. Centrally between the two is a nice little card table or just an area to put things on. And then you have a full dedicated wine bar. So that's one thing the French still lack is areas to stow all the wine. And on any boat, that is a great addition. Also, we have a utensil drawer in here as well. One thing I really want to point out, a couple things just as we go up forward to the master, is the louvered bulkheads. I find that to be quite unique. You know, you're seeing a lot of boats going with vinyl bulkheads, but I really like the solid wood bulkheads. Having the louvered just gives it a nice attention to detail. Our compression post is completely hidden here as well too. Nice stainless steel grab handles. We also have a lot of ambient lighting off to the side here. Those all have shades. All the windows have shades on them as well too. But as we move up forward, take a look at these hinges. I mean, this is the equipment that, you know, when you're looking for a solid offshore boat, it's just small attention to detail like this. These are solid hinges, big thick doors, amazing, you know, door handles here with magnet catches behind them. But we move up to the master stateroom, and I have to say, it's very impressive. I love that it has a full queen size bed here. We have a very large hanging locker, storage below that, a full vanity with a little bench seat here with a mirror mounted to that. Lots of overhead stowage here that wraps all the way around. Again, you look at the little attention to detail with the leather wrapped, you know, little trays here by the side of your bed. Steps giving you great access up into the bed itself. and massive amounts of cabinetry and door spaces. We have his and hers hanging locker again. So this is a nice hanging locker on this side. We have another hanging locker off to starboard. We have the whole parts here with the aviation style shades. Really, really impressive. And then we have our master head and shower. Now this head right here can be completely enclosed with a plexiglass door encompassing that entire shower compartment. We have molded sinks, a nice mirror, and behind the door here is a Japsco Quiet Flush electric toilet. This shower compartment, but as you can see, this closes off, magnetizes right into place, and now we have a full shower, a full bench seat here, and just a really nice area. And it doesn't take up that much real estate. That's what I like about this design. You see a lot of boats that really dedicate a lot of space to a shower, but now you're taking it out of the rest of the boat. So very, very well designed on Philippe Brion's. All right, so I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If you'd like more information in regards to the Jeanneau 519 Sun Odyssey, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tyle, at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business.